Lastly, if you want to pass on any message to the rest of the people in the group, please use the chat box right below. Additionally, I would like to request each one of you to rename yourselves in such a manner that we'd be able to identify if you are a member or a guest. Guests, please add a prefix guest before your name. And role players, please add the name of your role. For example, if I'm the grammarian for today, I would rename myself as Grammarian Toastmaster Abhirami. Also request the role players to ensure that your videos are switched on at least 2 minutes before your scheduled time. This will ensure us to smoothly transition you onto the stage. Without any further ado, let me hand over control to the presiding officer. He's a senior Toastmaster who's associated with the club since 2011. Recently, he's working as an assistant manager with Sundaram Clayton Limited. Let's put our hands together to call upon the president of our club, Toastmaster Guruvayurappan. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Abhirami, for the wonderful introduction. First, I declare open 746th meeting. I declare open 746th meeting. Am I audible?
Trust is
a keyword that everyone should have. First, they should trust themselves. Then others will also trust themselves. Let me share a story which I came across today. A businessman was traveling in a flight. After some time, the captain of the flight announced the beverages will not be served today because of heavy turbulence. After half an hour, again, announcement came from the captain that today's lunch or meals will not be served because of heavy turbulence. And after some time, what happened is the plane started flying zigzagly. It started flying up and down as it was about to crash. So suddenly there was chaos around inside the flight. Amidst all the chaos, the businessman noticed one small girl sitting in a corner, remained cool, calm and composed, reading a book, occasionally closing her eyes and saying something. So after all this chaos got over and suddenly after the flight got landed at the airport, everyone started rushing to get out of the flight. But this businessman waiting for everyone to get out because he wanted to meet and speak to that girl. So after everyone left the airport, he went and asked that girl, amidst all the chaos, how you remain cool, calm and composed? She promptly replied, my father is the captain of the flight. She is taking me back home. So that is the trust that she had on her father. So father and father's ability. Likewise, we should also have trust. If you want to be a good communicator or a good leader, you should have a good trust over your mentor, because your mentor only does good, what is good for you and what skills you need to improve and how to improve. So without much ado, I hand over control to today's Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Vratika Jain, who has completed her BE from BITS Pilani. And she is working in Mentor Graphics Corporation, Noida. Her hobbies are like dancing and she likes to play badminton also. Now, handing our control to TM Modi, Vratika Jain, Chadim, stage is over. Yours.
Thank you so much, presiding officer. Nothing is sure. That's for sure. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. I think now it is time for me to reveal what the theme actually is. So this is just for information for Marvel fans. What If is an upcoming American animated television anthology series based on the Marvel comics of the same name. It explores what would happen if major moments from the Marvel movies occurred differently. Do watch the trailer. It is quite interesting. So, on the similar lines, today we are going to find answers to some questions regarding what would have happened if things would not have happened the same way, or what would happen if things stop happening the way they do. So Toastmasters, wear your seatbelts and hold on to your chairs tight. This is going to be a wonderful ride. They say we grow up fast. What if it was not just an expression? What if instead of living a life for 80 years, we went through our life cycle in just 24 hours? Yes, you heard me right. Just 24 hours. Within a day, you would grow from a newborn baby to a senior citizen on his deathbed. Let's face it, guys. All of us are going to age. So let us first understand, why do we age? The cells in our body are constantly repairing and replicating themselves. This is because of a part of our DNA called telomeres. They protect our DNA during replication. But as we hit our 20s, this process starts to slow down because telomeres start to wear down. So now, the old cells cannot be replaced. But good thing, we have time. But what if we just had 24 hours? Let me give you an example of how our life would look like in just one day. So at 6 a.m., you're born. Welcome to the world. At 6:18 a.m., you're already an year old. You know how they say that the first year goes by so fast? Well, it did in just 18 minutes. At 7:47 a.m., you're ready for your first day at school. At 11:18 a.m., happy 18th birthday. 12:25 p.m., you just graduated from college. 1:25 p.m., you have found your significant other. And what's this? Are you starting a family? Oh, and by the way, you are now 25 years old. At 3 p.m., happy 30th birthday. At 6 p.m., happy 40th birthday. This is going by fast. At 9 p.m., happy 50th birthday. And at 1 a.m., you are 60 years old. It is time for retirement. Enjoy some rest and relaxation, because at 6 a.m., at 81 years old, you have passed on from this mortal world. But thankfully, this thing like living 81 years in just 24 hours doesn't actually exist. But it does makes you think that how important it is to use the time that we have. Life goes by pretty fast, those pastors. If you don't look around once in a while, you could miss it. So today, I would like all the role players to share with all of us what would they want to do if they only had 24 hours to live. It could be any sport, any place that you want to visit. It could be anything. Okay? So moving on, let me brief you all about today's meeting agenda. For the benefit of our guests as well, any Toastmaster meeting has three segments. The first is prepared speech session. Second is table topic session. And third, and the most important one, is our evaluation session. Before jumping on to the speech session, I would like to call upon our general evaluator for the day, who is none other than our distinguished Toastmaster Ram, to explain what an evaluation session is and how it will be conducted. To give a brief intro about him, he is working as a senior business analyst in STG. He loves reading books and going for long drives. Over to you, distinguished Toastmaster Ram.
Thank you, DM Vritika. Let me tell you a small story. Once a man was going and he saw a rough rock, and he saw one sculpture started working on that rock. And after a few days, when he came back, he saw a beautiful sculpture. When he praised the sculpture, saying, "You did a wonderful job and you made a wonderful idol," the person replied, "The idol was already there. I just removed unnecessary bits and pieces and polished it." Similarly, you have wonderful thoughts, wonderful ideas to share with us, but there will be some additional bits and pieces which needs to be removed. So my duty and my team's duty is to help you to remove those additional bits and pieces and polish your thoughts and ideas when you share them. To do that, I have a team of people who is going to help me. First person, in any speech, you don't need additional time being taken by your speech. So we have a timer who removes that additional time. Let me welcome our timer for today, Toastmaster Deepak, to explain his role. Deepak?
Hi, fellow Toastmasters and guests. As a timer, my role is to remind all the speakers how much time they spent on the speech so that we will run the meeting on time. So at the end of the day, at the end of the meeting, I will be back to present my report. The time for each speech will be, for the first speech, it is 4 to 6 minutes. And then for the remaining next and the upcoming speeches, two speeches, will be 5 to 7 minutes. A green card will be displayed in the first minute, that is the fourth minute. And then a yellow card will be displayed at the fifth minute. And then a red card will be displayed at 6 minutes. And for the remaining speeches, which is 5 to 7 minutes, a green card will be displayed at 5 minutes. A yellow card will be displayed at 6 minutes, and a red card will be displayed at 7 minutes. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Deepak. Next, when you are giving your good speech, unnecessary bits and pieces are ahs and ums. To help you to remove those pieces, we have another role player who is our counter. Today, our R counter is Toastmaster Guru. Guru, can you please read your objectives?
Yes, thank you, General Evaluator. So my role for today is to note down the bits and pieces like ums, ahs, and the unnecessary pauses used by speakers. And also note down the filler words like, so, but, now, okay. And I will note it down and I'll submit my report when I ask my GE at the end of the meeting. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Guru. Next, when you are giving your speeches, you need to remove some unwanted grammatical mistakes. So to help with that, we have our grammarian today, Toastmaster Jimmy. Jimmy, can you please tell your role?
Good evening, Toastmasters and guests. As a grammarian, I have two responsibilities. My first responsibility is to introduce the word of the day. The word of the day, as mentioned in the agenda, it is gawk. It's pronounced gawk. And the meaning is to gape or stare at something, often very openly and in a way that makes you look silly. So the use in sentences are like this. The newborn continued to gawk at his hand. I'll use in one more sentence. Curious fans often drove by film star's house to gawk. So I would encourage all the speakers to kindly use the word of the day. And my second responsibility is to comment on the good usages and not so good usages throughout the meeting. I'll submit my report when called upon by the General Evaluator. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jimmy. Next, to polish your speeches, we have team of evaluators. So they will be coming once the speeches during the last section of evaluation section. As a general evaluator, I will be evaluating the overall proceedings of this meeting. So I will submit my report towards end of the meeting. Thank you very much. Back to Toastmaster Ratika.
Thank you for briefing upon your roles and responsibilities and introducing us to your evaluation team. Next, we have Idiom Master of the Day, Toastmaster Kritika, to share the idiom of the day with all of us. She has completed her master's in HR and is currently interning in Ernst & Young. Please let us know, what would you do if you had only 24 hours to live? Over to you, Toastmaster Kritika.
If I had only 24 hours to live, I'd probably do everything that I could to make my parents happy. Thank you, Toastmaster Pratika. What is an idiom? An idiom is a metaphorical phrase that does not literally signify its meaning. So for example, let me give you some idioms. The first idiom is, ran into a bus saw. which means to encounter severe or unexpected problems. But the usage of this can be in, for example, the world ran into a buzzsaw during the COVID 2020 pandemic. Let me repeat, ran into a buzzsaw means encountering severe or unexpected problems. The second idiom is burning the midnight oil, which means to work late at nights. For example, of this end, of this idiom would be, my sister has been off late burning midnight oil to score an A+ in all her examinations. Let me repeat, burning the midnight oil. This means working late into the night. The third idiom is to let one's hair down. It means to enjoy or relax yourself. The example of this would be, post my end semester examinations last week, me and my friends have let our hair down, which means to enjoy or relax. The three idioms are ran into a buzz saw, which means encountering severe or unexpected problems. The second one is burning the midnight oil. For example, this is working late into the night. And the last idiom was letting your hair down, which means to enjoy or relax yourself. Over to you, Toastmaster Vratika.
Thank you, Toastmaster Kritika. These are quite interesting idioms. Next up, we have Courtmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Abhirami. To say a few words about her, she is a CA and is currently working at Barclays Bank. Over to you, Toastmaster Abhirami.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vratika. Sorry. Yeah. So I wake up on most mornings getting to see my dad doing his BP checkup. So there's this instrument which he puts onto his hand and checks where his BP is for the day, whether it's high or low. That's when I started thinking to myself, what if I had a machine which I could use to understand whether I'm feeling happy, whether I'm mentally well for the day, prepared for the day. That's when I realized I really don't need a machine to tell me whether I'm feeling mentally good. All I need to do is to sit back and ask myself very calmly whether I'm feeling good today, whether I'm happy, what I want, and to read my emotions. How many of us have time to do this simple task? We're all very busy with our day-to-day activities, Monday to Friday, running to office, weekend with the kids, family work, commitments, club, blah, blah, blah. But do we spend that 5 or 10 minutes with ourselves to recognize our own emotions? When I started asking myself this question, the answer was simply no. Half the time, I did not know what I felt, whether I was okay with something. Because I did not understand how I felt, I could not communicate effectively. Now, after this realization, I started reading a lot relating to psychology. And that's when I came across one of the quotes by a famous psychologist, Maya Angelou. She's a researcher in the mental well-being space. So she says, happiness is liking yourself, liking what you do, and also liking how you do it. I repeat, happiness is liking yourself, liking what you do, and also liking how you do it. This is a very simple but powerful quote. It all starts with whether you like yourself. If not, then you'll have to work to mold yourself to like yourself better. And you should start doing what you like. And also the procedures part, where you will ensure that the way you do it is also making you happy. Because at the end of the day, happiness is not going to magically fall down from the sky. You'll have to work to be happy. Because happiness is an art and you need to practice it. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster Vratika.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Abhirami. Now let us move on to prepared speeches session, the first session of the meeting. all the speakers might be thinking of various what ifs right now. Am I right? What if I stammer in between? What if I forget a line? What if my mic stops working? Let me assure you, Toastmasters, that all of you definitely have more than 24 hours to rectify your mistakes, incorporate the feedbacks given by our evaluators, and return with a bang next time. So just let go of all your what ifs and give your best. So our first speaker is Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayan. To say a few lines about him, he is working as a software engineer in Applied Materials India for the past 15 years. He's an electrical engineer by qualification, but software engineer by profession. Sir, I'm following your path. I would first like to call upon his evaluator, Toastmaster Geeta Shroff, to read out the speech objectives. Over to you, Toastmaster Geeta.
Good evening, everybody. Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayan is presenting his icebreakers today. So his objective is very simple. He just needs to learn the basic art of structuring his speech and in the process introduce himself to the club members. The time limit is 4 to 5 minutes. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Geeta. Let us welcome our first speaker, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayan. Who am I? Who am I, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayan?
Sir, unmute yourself.
Am I audible and visible?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, TMOD. One day I got a call from a marketing guy. He said, can I talk to Satya Narayana? I told him Satya Narayana is my dad. He is no more. He died 21 years back. And I also told him my name is Lakshmi Narayana. This is at least okay. The other day I got a call from a marketing guy. And even before I said hello, he will say, Lakshmi madam, we are offering a personal loan. There is always a confusion in my name, especially because of the lengthy first name and lengthy last name, and both ends with Narayana. Hence, I want to take this opportunity to introduce myself and walk through my childhood to where I am right now, and hence I titled, Who Am I? Good evening, Toastmasters and guests. This is Lakshmi Narayana, son of Satya Narayana. I was born exactly 46 years from now in a village between Madhavaram and Reddys. It's in northern Chennai. My father was a businessman, my mother was a housewife, and I have one elder sister. I did my schooling in St. Mary's, Perambur. After I completed my schooling in the year 1992, I joined SRM Engineering College, Kattangulathur for my BE. During my college days, I used to travel a distance of 50 kilometers, the first 5 kilometers by bicycle because I can't rely much on the local bus, the next 10 kilometers by MTC bus, and the remaining I cover by train. Sometimes when I don't have bicycle, I have to wait for hours for the local bus. And one day when I was waiting for the bus, a lady, a vegetable vendor, who's also a family friend, she was talking to me in Tamil about her son's education, who was studying BA in one of the local college in Chennai. She suddenly asked me about my studies. Usually when such question arises, I will say I'm doing second year in college or third year in college. The reason is I was the first guy from a village to go to an engineering college. So also my sister was the first girl to do her postgraduate in biochemistry from my village. But since this lady was talking about her son's education, I told her I'm studying third year BE. She immediately asked, Apo ABCD Murchitiya? Which literally means she thought BE is an extension of BA, BB and BC. I explained to her, BA is a Bachelor of Arts, a 3-year degree course, and BE is Bachelor of Engineering, a 4-year degree course, and I'm specializing in Electrical and Electronics Engineering. I think I confused her a lot. By the end of the conversation, she said, Yedo, na labadiya padichu or doctor velikachu po. Which literally means she expected me to become a doctor after I completed my course. This was a big joke for me at that point in time, because how can an engineer become a doctor? But later, when I met some of my college friends, I realized those guys completed their post-graduation and PhD, and they became doctors. So engineers can also become doctor, but just that they can't practice medicine. After my college, I joined HCL in the year 1997 as a software engineer trainee. The first thing they asked me is to create a short user ID, which eventually will become my email ID also. So I suggested them to create Lakshmi as my user ID, but they said, no, that will disappoint many guys in this office. Don't choose that word. So they came up with a short user ID, SLN, where S stands for my initial Satyanarayana, L for Lakshmi, and N for Narayana. And till date, I've been referred in my office circle as SLN. After for 7 years with HCL, I joined Applied Materials in the year 2015. I'm with this company till date. So, for though I didn't change my career for the past 15 years, a lot of things have changed in my life. I completed my post-graduation in business management from IMT. I got married in the year 2012. My wife, Bono, is working in government services. And I have one daughter who is 7 years old right now. When I first joined HCL, I thought my studies are over. I can start earning and enjoying my life. But I understood that there's no end to education. We have to keep learning, keep upgrading our skills, keep improving our skills, and keep learning more skills. So in order to improve my communication skills and transform from this monotonous speech to a more explosive speech, I rejoined CTM, and here I am as Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana. Over to TMOD.
Thank you, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana. Our second speaker is the one and only distinguished Toastmaster Nina John. She's a chartered member of CTM. She has been the past district director and chief judge of D82. The list is quite long. She is also a public speaking coach for CXOs and TEDx speakers and has authored a book recently. But first, I would like to call upon her evaluator and my mentor, Toastmaster Srikanth Kuttikrishnan, to read out the objectives of the speech. Over to you, Toastmaster Srikanth.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vatika. In today's meeting, I will be evaluating the speech of DGM Nina. She is presenting from Pathways Effective Coaching, Level 1, Project 2. The objectives of our project are for the speaker to select a topic of her choice and give and receive feedback.
Sir, just a minute. It is my HPL project.
But ma'am, in the, it is mentioned in the
event, they are the same. Sorry, my bad. I didn't see that. It wasn't there in the thing. But this is,
the agenda says Level 1, Project 2, Pathways Effective Coaching.
Yeah, that is correct. But there is something called HPL in that. High performance.
So that we can sort it out.
Okay, we'll do that.
Please send me the objectives of your speech.
Right. I'll do that. Sorry. Back to Wood.
Yeah, back to the first of the day.
Shall we start with the speech? Can Toastmaster Nina John, can you please confirm?
Yeah, it's level 5. Good evening. I'm sorry to interrupt. It's Venu from Effective Coaching Pathway. It's a level 5. And HPL is a high performance leadership. Yeah? And for that, she has to complete a project. Before that, she has to form a committee, guiding committee. I think it's an initial speech she is going to deliver. Right, ma'am?
probably we can, you know, discuss the subject. Meanwhile, Rotika, you can go to the next speaker and then we can come back to Neena, ma'am.
Sure. So the second speaker of the day is Toastmaster Rekha. To tell a few words about her, she owns a startup called Kalpataru Consulting, which is into project management training and consultation. She was the past president of CTM and is currently the secretary of CTM. Before listening to Toastmaster Rekha's speech, let us know her speech objectives. For this, I would like to call Toastmaster Puneet. Over to you, Toastmaster Puneet.
Madam Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters, and a special evening to my target speaker, Toastmaster Rekha ma'am in particular. Today, Toastmaster Rekha ma'am would be presenting a project from research and presentation from a pathway which is presentation mastery, which is L1P3, level 1 and project 3. So the purpose of this project is for Rekha ma'am to enlighten us in a well-organized and in a well-researched way. She'll be presenting on a particular topic in a well-researched manner. Timer, please note that the time is 5 to 7 minutes with a grace period of 30 seconds. Wishing Rekha ma'am all the best. Over to Toastmaster of the day.
Let us all give a virtual applause for our second speaker, Toastmaster Rekha. How to sell? How to sell, Toastmaster Rekha?
Good evening, my dear Toastmasters and guests. Stanford Business School research, when people listen, only 5% they recollect on statistics, but a whopping 63% recollect the story. This reminds me an Indian proverb. You tell me a fact, I learn. You tell me a truth, I believe. And you tell me a story, it lives in my heart forever. We as human beings started our storytelling journey way back from our caveman stage or era as paintings. And then the storytelling evolved over ages, taking the form of novels, movies, and now in the social media era as visual media. And there is a study that when a story is told, the information is well remembered. And a psychologist Jeremy Berner has said that 22% or 22 times we are likely to remember an information which has been wrapped up in a story. So why so much of impact by stories? So when we engage in a story, not only the brain is activated, the story appeals to the limbic brain. So the limbic brain is one part of our brain which processes the images, behavioral and the emotional responses. It evokes emotions. So story evokes emotions. So stories can move people to take action. Stories move people to buy products and by driven by emotions. Brands are almost built on moving stories. So my speech is based on research and presentation. So the materials and the methodologies which I have followed is observation. And I based on a book called Building a Story Brand by Donald. And then I interviewed a couple of storytellers, Miss Lakshmi and Miss Mr. Mohan, who is an ex-central banker and a professional storyteller. And his focus is more on corporate segments. So storytelling marketing is all about presenting a communication through narration. Its intent is to induce the feeling in the viewer for them to be motivated and to take action. So a story, always most of the stories follow a template, be it an entertainment story or a marketing campaign. So the template is like, there is a character and there is a conflict and then a resolution. Let me take an example of a Neuralex paint. So you would have seen this advertisement n number of times, where there is a doctor called Dr. Ghanshyam, where he would be watering the plant outside his old house. And there is a postman who always comes and throws the mails on him with disrespect. And likewise, let us take another example where there is a mom whose son is shot, and because of which the neighbor disrespects the mother and the child. So there are characters, and these characters in a story, there is always a character who has something to be addressed, some problem to be resolved. And in this case, the postman is the problem, the villain, and the neighbor in the case of the other advertisement. So we need to address the villain, and these villain or the problem should be visual. See, in case of a bad breath or a smelly toilet, then again, if you see, the marketers have visualized the problem in the form of green smoke or giant sized germs, so that the visualization of the problem makes a greater impact on the viewers, right? So this is one of the strategy. And now, so we saw there is a problem and there is a character, there is a problem. Now there is a guide who enters the situation. It can be a mother, father, a neighbor, a friend who introduces this product. So the product should, or the brand should, identify the problem of the customer. Only then the customer is going to recognize the brand, right? And now coming to back to our advertisement, so now there is a problem. So the problem need not be just an external problem. There is a physiological problem as well, or psychological problem. The embarrassment, the self-doubt, and the irritation has to be addressed by the brand. So the product or the brand not only addresses, for example, in this example, it is not only addressing the house or the height of the child, but the embarrassment also, or the self-doubt has to be addressed. Only then the audience is going to buy the product. And now next comes the action. So in an advertisement or a marketing campaign, there should be clearly an action plan, like how the product has to be used and where to buy. If this is not being clearly said, then the audience will not know what to do next. There is a clarity, there is no clarity, and there is no action next. And then there is a closure. See, it is not just the product, okay, not the external one. So the product, the marketing campaign should also visualize or create a fear in the audience, that loss of money or a tooth decay or a disgrace or a disrespect from the neighbor. So this has to be visually shown. So that instills the fear in the audience. The fear is the salt of the recipe. And then it has to be closed. Like after the use or the buying of the product and using of the product, how the life of the character has transformed. So that also has to be represented. Only then the audience will be able to feel it. For example, Princeton neuroscientist Yuri Hessen has spoken about brain coupling, which means when the audience, as an audience, when we see, we should also feel the delight, the happiness in using the product, and definitely we will buy it. So this is all about my research. And if you want to market your product, go for storytelling. Back to you, to the Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Rekha. It was indeed a great speech. Now let us welcome our third speaker of the day, distinguished Toastmaster Nina John. First, I would like to call upon her evaluator, Toastmaster Srikanth Kuttikrishnan, to read out the speech objectives. Over to you, Toastmaster Srikanth.
Thank you. Good afternoon once again. Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Vritika. Distinguished Toastmaster Nina is presenting her high performance leadership project, She would be delivering a speech based on her vision and mission for the club, and the speech would be evaluated on the basics and the fundamentals and what needs to be improved and where are the good points that her speech has incorporated. And the time given for it is 5 to 7 minutes, if I'm right. And all the best, DDM Nina. Over to you, Toastmaster of the Day, Ritika.
Let us all welcome distinguished Toastmaster Nina John, where leaders are made. Where leaders are made, distinguished Toastmaster Nina John.
Am I unmuted? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. You're audible.
All right. Before the timer starts, may I first start by apologizing to my evaluator, Toastmaster Srikanth, for that mix-up. And I should have read the agenda a little more clearly. So, sorry for that. Back to our thing. So, timer, you can start now. All right. Yes. A guest attends a Toastmaster meeting for the first time. A guest attends a Toastmaster meeting for the first time and is wide-eyed and starry-eyed at all those esteemed, wonderful speakers. And the first reaction is, I want to speak like X, or I want to be somebody like Y. As soon as the meeting is over, the guest will rush to that speaker and say, please, will you be my mentor? Now, this may actually be that person's second or third speech. Maybe he's a good speaker, maybe he or she is not a good speaker, but either way, they have done a great job on that day. And they're so fluttered at someone saying, come, will you be my mentor? That immediately they say, yes, of course. I will be your mentor, because what is mentoring after all? Look through a couple of speeches, correct a couple of grammatical mistakes here and there. After the speech is over, say good job and carry on. Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters and guests, mentoring is much more than just proofreading speeches. It is the molding of a Toastmaster towards his or her journey in Toastmasters and as a journey of self-discovery. History is replete with examples of mentors that have created proteges that have changed the world. Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, and of course, mentor, from whom we get the word mentor himself, have all created people that have changed the world. Aristotle taught Alexander, and Alexander became Alexander the Great. Incidentally, did you know that when Alexander the Great came to India, one of the kings that he fought was Bindusara, who was the grandson of Chandragupta Maurya, another great emperor, whose own tutor was Kautilya, or Chanakya, as we know him. So mentors have definitely affected world history. But in Toastmasters, what do we do as far as mentors are concerned? As I said, every second person decides, I've done a few projects in Toastmasters, somebody has asked me to be a mentor, and I can do it. But think about it, even if it is something as simple as the speech, there has to be something so systematic in even the way you do your projects, the way you handle your speeches, and how it's actually done. You have, for example, the speech process itself. Most mentees, no matter how approachable, knowledgeable, and sympathetic the mentor is, will dash off a speech on Saturday evening and say, "Toh, I have a speech slot for tomorrow. Please look through my speech and tell me what it is." But if you actually go through the process, both of you should sit, discuss, what are the ideas that I need for this speech? What do you think will work? 2 or 3 different drafts. Then you work out a script. Then you discuss the script. Then you go through rehearsal, tweaking, delivery in front of your mentor, delivery in front of the club, feedback and evaluation. 2 weeks is a minimum process for that. And from the audience reactions, I can see a lot of guilty faces as to who are the which are the mentors and the mentees and how they've been reacting so far. But remember, it's not just speeches that the mentor is in charge of. The mentor is actually an advisor, a friend, philosopher, and guide who helps you avoid the buzzsaw reaction, helps you understand what are your strengths, what are your weaknesses, and what can you do in Toastmasters. Helps you in terms of leadership. Gives you that little push to say, you can be a member of the XCOM. Come on, you can do this. Tells you, this is how you should do the role play. This is what you should do for TMOD. These are the ideas you should do for our counter. This is what you should do for attending meetings. Just take up one role. 2 minutes is all it takes. That little encouragement is what makes the difference. Push them into leadership positions. Push them into taking up responsibilities. Do a little thing for the magazine. It'll help your English. It'll help the club. Come on, about 2 hours of your time is all it needs in a week. When a mentor helps a person to grow, that's when a mentor does it. In Toastmasters, in D120, we're trying to build up this mentor pool. We're looking at a series of mentor pool coordinators, building up mentors from every club, giving them processes, giving them practices, showing what is the philosophy of Toastmasters. I have been tasked with this by our district director, Praveen Mani. We are going to build up this mentor pool by having mentor pool coordinators all the way from the grassroots clubs up to the district level. We intend training mentors as far as possible, and we know that this will help in terms of member connection, member relationship, building up club quality, and ensuring that D120 will improve in terms of quality of members and of all the leaders as well. This is not an instant overnight Maggie Noodles project. We know we cannot build skyscrapers, but we can plant the seeds. We know we have fertile soil in Toastmasters, and this is where we will help plant those seeds, nurture people. Because in Toastmasters, this is where leaders are made. Back to you, Madam Toastmaster.
This was a great speech, ma'am. This brings us to the end of our first session. I would request the timer to quickly read out the time taken by each speaker.
Hi. I will share the screen. So please let me know once you're able to see.
Yes, it is visible.
Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana has taken 5 minutes and 56 seconds. Toastmaster DTM Nina Jan has taken 6 minutes, 39 seconds. And Toastmaster Rekha has taken 7 minutes and 29 seconds. So all of them are eligible. Thank you.
Thank you so much, timer. Now I would request the host to launch the polls for prepared speakers.
Hello, is the poll?
Shall I continue with the meeting?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Coming back.
Unmuted.
You are muted.
Coming back to our theme of the day, are you all excited to know about the next what if? Before revealing that, let me take you back to your childhood. Remember that unsatisfactory feeling as a kid when you would try to jump into the air thinking that you're Superman and something brings you back to the ground? Well, that something was your mother. No, wait, that's everyone's mother, which is gravity. Just like your mother, it's always there, it never changes, and you can never, ever break its rules. But that's for the better, right? What if there was no gravity on Earth? What if for just a few seconds, this gravity was switched off? Would anybody like to share what would they do if there was no gravity on Earth? Anybody from the audience? You can unmute yourself.
I can pluck the apples from the tree myself.
That's a great idea, I must say. Anybody else?
If there is a method to navigate, I think that's the best thing to happen because we don't require any vehicles to commute.
That's interesting, right? But I'm afraid that the ending would not be so happy. Let me tell you, from the universe to our solar system, to each planet, and all the way down to our own bodies, gravity holds everything together. It is because of gravity that we have water to drink and air to breathe. In order to give you an idea of how important gravity is in a really, really short time, I am going to take it away from you. Not for too long, just for 5 seconds. Are you ready? Remember I asked you to hold on tight to your chairs in the very beginning. That was for a reason. So I want all of you to unmute yourself and count down with me from 5 till 1. After that, we'll switch off gravity. Are you all ready?
Yes.
Unmuted?
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Fire.
Switched off. You are all now floating above the ground. But with the world still spinning at its usual 1,600 kilometers per hour speed, everything would go flying. Cars, boats, trains, planes, and even people. We could experience winds as strong as, at least 6 times stronger than the cyclone Varda. That means in just 5 seconds, you could be flown as far as 2.5 kilometers away in just any direction. And it will not be just you. There'll be plenty of people, objects, and animals to look out for. Also, the gases in the atmosphere would start to drift out into the space. So now we are not only losing a lot of oxygen, but the instant decrease in air pressure would shatter our ears. Then comes the planet itself, which is literally held together by gravity. The pressure of the Earth's inner core would cause the planet to expand if there's no gravity. And even a 5-second expansion can cause some major earthquakes and some destructive volcanic eruptions. Add another item to your list of dangerous things flying through the sky. That is lava. Now, let us switch on. Let us restore the gravity. I'm afraid the transition would not be this smooth, just like this action. You would hit the ground hard. And if that doesn't kill you, there'll be plenty of objects falling through the sky. And there will be still floods and earthquakes, because in this 5 seconds, the planet literally just opened up and swallowed some of the major cities of the world. The casualties would be astronomical. So a lot can happen in just 5 seconds. You may think that you are special, and you certainly are, but you must remember that you are a part of something bigger than you, and that's what keeps you grounded. All right? With this note, let's quickly move on to the most heart-throbbing session of this meeting, that is the table topic session. And for this, I would like to call upon table topic master of the day, which is Toastmaster Cholin, to say a few lines about him. He's a consultant and is running finance and trading companies. And he said that, in short, he's awesome. So, hoping for an awesome table topic session from you, Toastmaster Cholin, the stage is yours. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vatika. That awesome part is, it's a joke. It's not necessary to tell that. Okay, good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. I'm a table topic master. Table topic session will improve your impromptu speaking and the spontaneity. I am very, very excited to be a table topic master, because I'm the only one who asks the questions. And for the guest, time allotted for each table topic speaker is 2 minutes, maximum 2 minutes. At the in 1 minute, the green light will show. In 1 minute, 30 seconds, yellow light will show. And the 2 minute, the red card will show by the timer. After that, you get 30 second grace period. Okay. Now the first speaker is Toastmaster Satish Babu. Unmute yourself, Satish Babu. Toastmaster.
Okay. Yeah, Cholin. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, tell me, Cholin.
Okay. Do you believe in fake it until you make it? Do you believe in fake it until you make it?
Do you believe in fake it or make it, right?
Until you make it.
Until you make it. So, thank you so much, TT Master, for the wonderful topic. Pull it and make it. As per my understanding, without making anything, without done anything, we should not explore ourselves. I can do this. I cannot do this. Taking for example, in my own life, I have went for a lot of interviews when I completed my college. Before I got my first job, I attended for a minimum 50 to 70 interviews. All the interviews, the interviewer said that same thing. Without improving your communication skills, nobody will give you the job. But whenever I attend for the interview, I believe that that is the place where I can improve my communication. So as far as increasing the interview, I can learn the communication from the based on interviews I'm attend. So once I did it and I spoke to the same interviewer when they told me the same thing, then now I got a good job in a bank, and they told me that I agree based on your hard work and based on your continuous assessment in your work, you got this. So now I understand that before make anything, we should not say anything. So I can say this thing, we should not say anything to the new person without doing for the better things. Once we prove that, definitely we can tell them same thing to the person. This is the thing I have done in my life. So over to you, Toastmaster Cholin.
Thank you, Toastmaster Satish Babu. Exactly, this is what I believe. Fake it and until you make it is not a good choice. Okay, the second speaker is guest Mithun Ramesh. Are you there?
Yeah, okay. I'm here.
Okay, your question is, if you get a chance to buy a luxury item, which one you will buy and why? Do you understand? Can I repeat this question?
I understood.
Okay.
So I'd rather buy an expensive laptop. Rather, it sounds strange, but the laptop what I have currently it's hard to work with Excel and all. We are using office laptops, which is around 1,30,000 or something. So the current laptop, whatever, it is not performing that much. So I'd like to have, because during this lockdown, my entire life revolves around laptops. Be it office, be it Toastmasters, everything, it depends on a laptop, even mobile games and all. So if I have a quality or a premium laptops, I could make a lot of money. So it might sound silly, but you can make a lot of money using laptops, in fact, because if you see a lot of YouTube videos, they've started making mobile gaming like PUBG, Free Fire, chess, even they're taking a lot of online classes for public speaking. A lot of stuff are happening just by sitting in front of a computer. You can do a lot of stuff. So this lockdown period has taught me that you can make a lot of money if you have a quality laptop and if you can provide a quality content. So not just that, even Toastmasters, sitting here, we are able to attend a lot of meetings. A lot of if it was a physical meeting, we would be attending only one club. But sitting here, I could attend meetings across the globe, not just in India. So to me, it would be rather a laptop, a quality laptop, which can fulfill all my day-to-day activities, like be it office, YouTube contents and stuff, even Toastmasters and stuff. That's it. Over to you, Toastmaster Cholan.
Thank you, Mithun Ramesh. I gave a chance to buy a luxury item, but you said you want a laptop. It shows your productivity level. Okay. Then next speaker is Toastmaster Kritika. Are you there?
Yes, tell me, Toastmaster.
What is something you believe that other people think is crazy?
I'm sorry? What?
What is something you believe that other people think this is crazy?
Something that I believe that other people think is crazy.
Actually, you believe something.
Okay.
It's good to you, but others think this is crazy.
Okay. Let me tell you what I believe firstly. I think I have been brought up in a conservative family earlier on, because I was living in a joint family during my younger days. So I am very, very, very attached to my family members. A lot of my friends find that a little different. Not that they're not attached to their family, but we meet almost every week. During the pandemic, I think that has been one thing that is not happening. But my closeness with my family members and my cousins is something that a lot of people do not get very easily. And I think I'm very, very, very fortunate to have great cousins and a great family. And I'm really missing them during the pandemic, because in this 6 to 7 months, I would have met them at least 10 to 15 times if it was a regular year. And a lot of us have graduated, finished our college life, and still we're not able to meet each other. That is something that I really believe is a little this and that. But apart from that, I think a family culture is shown in a lot of people. A lot of people have different personalities, and that is one reason why their thoughts might not match with another person. But in that case, also, me and my family, I belong to a very close-knit circle. And I trust and I'm very loyal to my family. So not just with the people who are living with me here right now, but also with my extended family. I think family plays a huge role in one's upbringing, in one's life, in framing one's culture and personality. So I think being an open culture, belonging to a great and close-knit family is something that I've loved. And that's something that other people don't get very often. So that way, I think that's something that I believe in, being close to your family. Over to you, Toastmaster Cholan.
Thank you, Toastmaster Kritika. That's not a crazy thing. If someone thinks this is crazy, then they are crazy. Okay, the next speaker is guest Hari. Are you there, guest Hari?
I'm there.
Okay. Your question is, what is the one worst advice you will receive or hear in 2020?
What is the worst advice you have received or you would receive?
You received.
Okay.
Or hear.
Yeah, the worst advice, I'm a salesperson, and the worst advice I received in the beginning of January was my colleague was advising me that you should go to Japan, you should go to Korea, you should go to US, and you should go to Canada and all around the world. And he said, you have to make sure that we establish new clients there and also open office there and so on. So I started planning all the things over there, only to see that the trip to Japan got blocked. Trip to US now actually have opened up, but still we cannot travel easily. Only through Vande Bharat we can travel. Even my colleagues don't want to travel along with me. So it's kind of a worst advice which he gave, and which, I mean, he tried his part of it. I mean, he did the best. But fortune turned the other way, like I could not travel anywhere, and a lot of planning was done on the first 2 months. Like until March, I was planning a lot, and it turned out that I couldn't meet any of the travel things. Even now, I'm trying to travel to Japan. I knocked the Japan consulate, called them, whether I can travel. They said, all your business visa has been under suspension, you cannot travel. And US, I'm trying to book a ticket. Unfortunately, I'm not able to get a ticket, but my colony colleagues are all like old parents. They are able to travel and meet, but I'm not able to travel. I don't know why. Yeah, that's the kind of worst advice I would say, and it landed on the wrong side. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, guest Arish. I learned a lesson too. Okay, any volunteers?
Shall I take a chance?
Yes. What's your name?
Devi.
Okay. Guest Devi. Who do you think of when you hear the word successful?
So there's no one like the successful person. I would say everyone is a successful person in our everyday to-day life. When we have a problem, when we come out of it, then we would be a successful person. So there is no such person called without any problems. So I have met so many people who were the known people for everyone, but they are doing their best at each and every level. Whatever they do on their task, that would be fine. So that is how I measure successes. And whenever I see the person in their perspective, it is really a very awesome one. Even we would get the lesson from them. So that is how I got to know about so many people who are very simplest, but by their actions, while they get into the problem, when they take a solution, so they would become a successful person. So that is how I think it's a I would take it. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, guest Devi. That's awesome. Any volunteers? Okay. Toastmaster Deepak. Can you unmute yourself?
Hi, Toastmaster Cholan.
Your question is?
Sorry, Cholan. Since I am the timer for the day, I request someone else to do the time.
Okay, I can pick that up.
Okay. It's Abhirami. Who's that?
Yes, Abhi here.
Yeah, okay. What is the most important quality leaders must possess?
Yes. So thinking about leaders, there are 3 to 4 qualities I feel leaders should possess. One being finding a solution, how innovative the leader is thinking. And then the leader should keep sense of his time and when to intervene and when to hold back. Also, the leader should motivate. So how effectively the motivation is set. So what is, and also the fourth agenda is being stick to the schedule or stick to the plan, the greater plan. So which benefits the organization or which benefits his as well as his mentees or his teammates or whatever it is. And that is the four main objectives which results in drive for results. And the effective communication should also tag along with all these parameters which I mentioned. So this is what I feel an effective leader should have in his mind. Thank you, Toastmaster Chol. This is what I think.
Thank you, Toastmaster Deepak. Yes, it's true. If you want to be a leader, you must possess that communication skill.
Thank you.
Okay. Next, Toastmaster Abhirami. Are you there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hi, Jordan. Yeah.
The question is, do you live your life by any quotes?
Okay. So, do I live my life by any quotes?
Yeah.
Yes. The answer to this one would be a big yes. This was years ago when I believed that we were all given a code of conduct when we were born. There were rules set upon as to what you could do, within what time you could do, how all you could speak, how you shouldn't speak. Everything is predefined. And all you just need to do is to follow that. And life went on like this for years and years. I was one of the most obedient and disciplined student, not just at school, but also at home. So there's no naughty things, nothing. It was all aligned. It was like military. But after a certain point, following the codes of conduct that is put onto my head, I realized life is about learning and framing your own code of conduct, because you live your life and you realize what works for you, because what works for you may not work for someone, and what someone said may not work for you. The wider rules, yes, there are great people who have experienced things and they give it to you on the plate so that you don't need to do everything again and learn that. But it's good to experience certain things yourself and then frame your code of conduct. So yeah, so my codes now keeps changing now and then. There's no standard big codes, except for the fact that whatever you do, do things which is going to make you happy and ensure you do not, even if you don't help people, don't ruin others. And where possible, help people a little where it works. It'll make you really more happy than whatever you are. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster Cholin.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhirami. Exactly. This is how I live now. Okay, the next speaker is Toastmaster Puneet.
Yes, Cholan, mm-hmm. Please tell me.
Okay.
Yeah.
The question is, what are some of the choices you have made that made you who you are?
Excellent. So, thankfully, I have my father nearby. So, anyways, he'll also enjoy listening to me. So, what is the choices which has made me who I am? Okay, first of all, being from a Marwadi background, my father always gave me the freedom to choose whatever I want. Although technically I did big injustice to my community. I'm supposed to take commerce and join business, but I did the opposite because I wanted to be the different one. And he was very supportive about that. And then I chose physics, chemistry, maths. Yeah, that's my father. He's the backbone of mine. Anyways, he's doing his work. Yeah, having said that, physics, chemistry, maths, I went with this third mentality as how everybody does. If you're from south of southern part of India, that's what all of us will do. Then joined a good university called Amrita. I must say one of the best universities in Coimbatore, not in the world. They market themselves as the best universities. But then after joining Amrita, somewhere in the middle, I realized engineering is not my cup of tea, but I somehow managed to ace it thanks to the Toastmasters community. And I think that really helped me to stand apart, at least when it comes to table topic. Because being a seven-pointer, how do you expect to get placed in core company? And I think that one choice which I made, that one investment which I made long time back, has paid me reaps of rewards. I can be honest in admitting that I'm an average student, just a 7.5, that's the GPA which I have. But this amazing community of Toastmasters did help me. And yes, there were also efforts from my end as well. So I think that's it from my side. I would like to say that Toastmasters did played one role. It has shaped me who I am. But I think I'll not limit myself to Toastmasters as well. I think the world is a lot more bigger. Toastmasters is just one small, probably I would call it a small ocean. There's bigger opportunities for us out there in the world. And I think let's make the maximum out of it. And at the same time, I'm reminded of this one quote by, I think, Lord Buddha. I think we have the freedom to make choices, but are always bound by the consequences of it. So whatever decision we take, let's make it to the fullest. And even Ratan Tata also, I can quote it. I don't make the right decision. I take the decision and make it right. So I think that's one thought which I would leave up to you. So whatever decisions you have taken, take it and make it right. Choose it and you're bound by the consequences of it. And I thank you, this beautiful community of Toastmasters. And yes, of course, my father as well. Over to Toastmaster Chola.
Thank you, Toastmaster Puneet. I like your spontaneity. Okay, any volunteers? Okay. Toastmaster Soma. Are you there? Okay, no. Okay. Toastmaster Srikanth Kuttikrishnan.
Thank you, Cholan.
Thank you, sir. The question is, I am an old man and I have known a great many troubles, but most of them never happened. I repeat the question. Yes.
The first part is very clear. I am an old man.
I am an old man and have known a great many troubles, but most of them never happened.
Yeah. That reminds me in the year 2001 when Chennai had a earthquake. I was there on the fourth floor apartment and I really panicked. My grandmother, who was 89 then, was with me. So I had to literally grab her, carry her literally. She was a very timid person. We came down to the ground floor and all of us, the neighbors, were in the open ground. And after some time, people started going back home. But I couldn't muster the courage to get back home for the fear of that there could be a tremor afterwards. Aftershocks could happen is what was lingering in my mind. I couldn't muster the courage. I didn't want to go home that night. I started to panic. And literally I had to go through a lot of therapy and I had to meet a psychologist. I was put on medication. And what I realized from that is, and science has proved it right, most of our fears never happened in our life. 90% of the fears that people think would happen never really happened. That's one thing that I've learned and I started living by that. And fear is something that we have to get rid in our life. And for sure, I have done that. Thanks to the experience that I had with the earthquake that happened, I still live in the fourth floor apartment and never felt that there could be a tremor again. Thank you very much. Back to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Srikanth Kuttikrishnan. Any volunteers? Okay. Toastmaster Ranju.
Yes, Toastmaster Chola.
Okay. Your question is, if you want to lead, you have to first learn how to follow.
If you want to lead, you first have to learn how to follow.
How to follow.
Good evening, dear Toastmasters. And thank you for this wonderful topic, Toastmaster Cholan. So this is one such quote which I've heard multiple times in my life so far. In my 27 years I had so far. First, I used to hear it a lot of times from my dad. He used to tell me the same thing. कि डोंट गेट इन टू द बेनिफिट्स पार्ट फर्स्ट डू द ग्राउंड वर्क सो एंड आफ्टर दैट आई जॉइंड इंजीनियरिंग वेयर इट वॉज मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग एंड देयर ऑल्सो व्हेन वी यूज टू गो टू द हाई लेवल एस्पेक्ट्स पीपल यूज टू से यू शुड गो एंड लर्न द बेसिक्स लर्न हाउ अ मशीन वर्क्स बिफोर यू कैन एक्चुअली गो एंड मैनेज इट सो that is literally the path which I have sort of taken. I first did my engineering in mechanical and then I went on to do my operations management studies in Mumbai. So first I got to learn about production and the basics of all the machines and then I got to do a management studies in the same, which was a good path. And even there I felt that if I have not done this particular engineering aspect and if I have joined there, it would make no sense at all. So I would totally agree on this point. If you have to lead or if you have to, you know, look at things from a bird's eye view or a larger perspective, you need to know the basics. And that is absolutely true. And thank you for this wonderful topic. Over to you, TT Master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ranju. Yes, leading is always a tough. Following is easy. Okay. The next speaker is guest Roop Singh.
Yes.
Okay. The topic is.
I don't want to switch on the video, please.
It's okay.
Okay.
Aim for the heart, not the head.
Aim for the heart.
Yes, aim for the heart, not the head.
Really, this is everything what you aim has to be from heart, actually. So whatever you do, whatever you make a goal in your life, it has to be from your heart, not from head, actually. Because heart, whenever you do something from heart, then only you will get 100% chance of a success. So it is a good thing to anything you do, you should do from your heart. Anything should not be done which is not from your heart. So that is the main crux of this. So anybody wants to achieve something in life, that has to be done from your heart. Like the health point of view also, now a lot of this is going on, COVID problem. So you have to start up from your heart, because doing yoga, and you should take up many things to improve your immunity. So that has to, because many a times people tell I will do this, I will do this, but sometimes they lose the stream and they start doing just for the sake of doing. But that should not be done. So everything has to be done from your heart. That definitely there is a chance of 100% getting success. Over to Solan.
Thank you, guest Roop Singh.
Thank you for
That's
giving
wonderful.
Me the opportunity.
Okay, now it's the end of the TT session. Thank you, speakers and guests, to participate in this session. Over to you, Toastmaster Vritika.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Cholan. It was a great session. I would request the timer to let us know the name of the TT speakers who have qualified. I would request you to read out the names and not the timings, just the names.
Yes. Hello. I'll just read out the names. Toastmaster Satish Babu and all the table topics members who have spoken is eligible. That's what I'm seeing.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Now, coming to the most important session of the meeting, that is the evaluation session. I would request our general evaluator, distinguished Toastmaster Ram, to conduct the session. I hand over the controls to you, sir.
Thank you very much, Ritika. So as I said in the beginning, to polish your speeches, we have a team of evaluators who are going to evaluate the prepared speeches. So to evaluate first speech by Lakshmi Narayan, I request Toastmaster, Madam Toastmaster Geeta, to do the evaluation. Madam Toastmaster.
Yeah. Good evening, everybody. Yeah. The secret of getting ahead is getting started. Kudos to Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayan for starting his journey on the Toastmasters. So your speech objectives were very simple. You were required to tell us something about yourself or introduce yourself to the club members. And in the process, you present to us a very structured speech. True to that, your speech was well structured. And in the process, we learned a lot about you. You told us that you've joined the Toastmasters so that you can make your monotonous speech more expressive. Let me tell you, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayan, your speech wasn't monotonous. We really enjoyed listening to you. You had amazing sense of humor, and the way you had expressed how people, they confuse your name or your interaction with the vendor, how she blessed you to come out as a successful doctor when you were pursuing your Bachelor of Engineering, or how your username, you had to choose it as something like abbreviation of your name instead of using Lakshmi. So that was really wonderful, and we were really interested in and loved listening to you. In the process, you also had a message for all of us. You said learning is a continuous process. We should never quit learning. So this is something very inspiring to all of us. So I'm sure you're going to have a wonderful journey in the Toastmasters. You have definitely joined a wonderful forum where you can hone your speaking skills. Coming to a few recommendations, I would just tell you, maybe I wanted to know more about your childhood days. And probably you could have told us something about how your parents had impacted you and bringing to what you are today. This is basically because you told us that you're coming from a village where not many were pursuing their higher education. From that kind of a scenario, you've been brought up and you have pursued your engineering and you have been working in HCL for 15 years. So in the process, I would have definitely, or even for most of us, all the Toastmasters, I'm sure, would love to know how they have impacted you to reach to this kind, to this extent. So overall, you had an amazing speech for all of us. And it was a beautiful way of presenting to yourself to the club members. And the speech was really well structured. You were very confident. You were very expressive. And you are definitely in the right forum where you can hone your speaking skills. And this is definitely not a monotonous speech. It was a really interesting speech. And I'm sure this forum is going to help you to be more expressive and more polished. And I'm sure you're going to have a great success in your upcoming endeavors. With this, I hand over the proceedings to the general evaluator. Over to you.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster Geeta, for the wonderful evaluation. Let us have next polishing done by TM Puneet to evaluate our second speaker, TM Rekha. Toastmaster Puneet, please provide your
evaluation. Yes, DTM Ram. Yes, thank you so much, DTM Ram. On this amazing Sunday evening, what an informative speech to be listened for all of members out here and even as guests. Thank you, Toastmaster Rekha, for providing us an informative speech on how to sell. So what are three things which I really loved in your speech? Number one, compelling opening. Number two, informative body. Number three, the core message. I love the way in which you quoted Stanford Business School as to how storytelling is remembered longer when compared to statistics. Number two, informative body. You brought in credible sources, persons as well. Just to name a few, you brought in, just a moment, you brought in Mr. Lakshmi, who's an ex-banker, central banker. Then you brought in Yuri Hassan, who is Princeton neuroscientist. There were a lot of amazing takeaways in that process. And more importantly, I love these lines when you said about how marketeers address the pain point, the challenges through visual medium. And my favorite line was throughout the speech was this one line, fear is the salt, which is exploited really well by marketeers. message itself. If you want to market a brand, go through storytelling. A simple, clear message. Now, since you're a senior Toastmaster, I would predominantly focus more on recommendation. So my first recommendation would be clarity with regards to anecdotes and numbers. For example, I love the example which you said about Nerolac. I was able to visualize well because we have seen this ad through in our television. But when you are saying second anecdote, I was not able to understand a bit. Maybe if you had given the brand name, would have been better for me to understand. Even when you quoted Jeremy Berner, one of the psychologists, you are actually a bit confused whether it was 22% or 22 times. How storytelling impacts in a much more better manner. And even the book which you quoted, in fact, I have Google right in front of me, building a story brand. You said Donald, and then you were lost for words. You were trying to recollect the names. So the author name is Donald Miner, which I just checked. So a little bit of preparation would have definitely helped in that process. Point number two, which is pace and pause. I loved the way in which you captivated the opening of your speech. I was longing for it till the end. I would have really loved if when you are moving from one anecdote to the another, and even from one speech of the one part of your speech to the another, I would have really loved those time pauses. It was there in the first 20 to 30 seconds of your speech, which was very captivating. I would have really loved if you had inculcated throughout your speech. And last but not the least, the conclusion. Since I appreciate the fact that you managed to clock in 7 minutes 29 seconds, which just goes to show that you somehow ended it when you saw the red card. Respect the fact that you have given us a good message, but allow me as a listener to understand what you have said and then wait for 2 seconds and then give the message. If you want to market a product, go through storytelling. In that way, the impact is much more better because pauses are the most powerful thing in a speech. So to wrap it up and to sum it up, love the compelling opening. Informative body is something which I really appreciate. Love the core message. Work on pause and pace, and more importantly, clarity with regards to numbers and anecdote, and you will be a person who will be sold, not just here, but here. Over to DTM, Ram.
Thank you, Toastmaster Puneet, for your energetic evaluation. To polish the third speech by DTM Nina, we have our Toastmaster Srikanth to evaluate her speech. Toastmaster Srikanth, please evaluate the third speech.
Thank you, General Evaluator. When I heard DTM Nina speak, I knew we have a word wizard amongst the myth. Beautiful usage of English vocabulary. Few of them were wide-eyed, starry-eyed, history is replete, wonderfully used. And the best part of your speech was that you literally gave a guide, a recommendation of how a Toastmaster needs to select their mentor. Not only in Toastmaster, but also in real life. And also you told us a few very good examples of mentoring. You had Aristotle quoted, who mentored Alexander the Great. And you also had a couple of other real-time heroes who mentored their mentees very well. A very well delivered speech. I really appreciate the fluency in which you brought up such a big topic of mentoring, threadbare and simple to all of us. I really like the story that you have narrated about all these mentoring. And you also gave us a few examples for the Toastmasters who joined Toastmasters and asking them not to get carried away by just listening to a speaker who gave a good speech on that particular day. And you also told us how we should present our speech to our mentors, not on a Saturday evening, but at least 2 weeks ahead. That was well received. I'm sure with a lot of new members signing up with the CTM, that was a very wonderful and very relevant speech. I really liked that. The overall presentation was amazing, clear, and all of us understood. I'm for sure learned a lot from what you have said. Having said this, what I would like for you to incorporate in the speech that you have just delivered was, what was your personal experience? Who was your mentor? How did he or she mentor you? And what did you gain from that? And also, since you are giving such a wide topic in a concise way, a little bit of humor. I'm sure you should have had some funny moments with your mentor or something like that. You have some examples to say about sharing of mentorship and humor that you had. That would have made your speech really wonderful. Being a very eloquent speaker, I'm sure these are the points that I would like you to work upon. Otherwise, it was a wonderful speech. So to give you my evaluation in a nutshell, a well-delivered speech with examples, real-life experience, and lot of takeaways for everyone who are listening to your speech. If you could bring in a little bit of your personal experience with your mentor and a little bit of humor, I'm sure your speech would have been a showstopper for any meeting. I wish you all the very best, Divya Meena. Looking forward to evaluate once again. Back to the general evaluator. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Toastmaster Srikant, for your insightful evaluation. Let us move on to removing those bits and pieces from that rough rock in our speeches. Let us have first our timer to give his report to see if everybody is doing well on the timing.
Yes, everyone is within the time limit. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Can we have voting for the best evaluator? While we wait for the evaluator voting, let us move on to the report from our timer. Can you please give the report of your timer report?
Yes. I'm just voting, just give me a second.
Okay.
Yes. So the Toastmaster Geeta, the evaluator number one, has completed in 3 minutes, 5 seconds. Toastmaster Puneet, 3 minutes, 21 seconds. And Toastmaster Srikant has done in 3 minutes and 6 seconds. This will be the actual timing eligible will be 2 minutes to 3 minutes. And with a grace period of 3 minutes and totally 30 seconds in addition to the time limit. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Next, we will have our R-counter report. Can we have our R-counter give his report? Guru.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Now it's time for me to submit my bits and pieces of report. Sergeant at Arms, 1 hour. Abhirami, 1 hour. Presiding Officer Guru at 3 hours and 1 pause. Toastmaster of the day, Vratika, at 1 hour, 1 am and 1 so. Idiom Master Kritika, Courtmaster Abhirami, General Evaluator Ram Mohan, DTM Nina John, Evaluator Puneet, TT Master Cholan, Timer Deepak, and TT Speaker Srikant, TT Speaker Ranju, TT Speaker Rupushing had no us, no filler words, no pause. Please give a big round of applause for them. Now coming to the remaining part, Prepared Speaker Lakshmi Narayana had 1 serve, Prepared Speaker Rekha had 3 plus hours, and our favorite words are and, so, and 2 passes. Evaluator Geeta had 3 plus hours, Evaluator to Srikant had 3 plus ands, Evaluator 3 Puneet flawless. Then table topic speaker Satish Babu 3 plus source and 1 off. Table topic speaker 2 Mithun Ramesh 3 plus or 3 plus or and but. Kritika 3 plus or 3 plus but 3 plus and. Guest Ari 3 plus or 3 plus and. Guest Devi 3 plus or. Deepak 3 plus source. Abhirami so and 3 plus or. Puneet 1 so. Table topic speaker Puneet 1 so. That's all my report. Over to General Evaluator.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Guru. Next, let us have our grammarian report. Toastmaster Jimmy, can you please give your grammarian report?
Thank you, DTM Ram. Good evening again, Toastmasters and guests. I must tell you, I'm a little disappointed that nobody used the word of the day. So I think I would encourage every speakers always do remember to use the word of the day. Today's word of the day was gawk. There were quite a few good usages today. I appreciate the Toastmaster of the day for her flawless English and a very simple language she has used. She has used good usages like on the similar lines, the virtual applause. Toastmaster Rekha has used character, conflict and resolution, which is a good usage. Fear is the salt of the recipe. Toastmaster DTM Nina John has used history is replete with story of mentors. Instant overnight Maggie noodles project. I felt it's a good usage. I could relate to it. Toastmaster Puneet used a compelling opening informative body. He used numbers and anecdotes. Toastmaster Srikant, the feedback in a nutshell, a showstopper, eloquent speaker, all good usages. Our Courtmaster Kritika ran into a busso, burning the midnight oil to let one's hairs down, are all good usages. Not so good usages, a example is ideally used as an example. A special good evening to my target speaker. In particular, I doubt the correctness of that. It can be better as a special good evening to my target speaker, or a good evening to my target speaker in particular. Back to you, to the TMOD. It can be better used as back to you, back to the Toastmaster of the day, or it can be used as back to the Toastmaster of the day. That ends my report, and over to you, General Evaluator. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Jimmy. Can we have a vote for the best? Let me give my report first, sorry. So as part of my report, I can say meeting started on time. That was wonderful. And even before that, I have to commend the excellent job of our VPE. I can see he is continuously, throughout the week, he is preparing for the meeting and he was continuously sending the messages. That was wonderful. Next, speakers did a wonderful job in their speeches, and evaluators give insightful and helpful evaluations. And I have to appreciate our Toastmaster of the day. She is doing it for the first time and did a wonderful job. She started with enthusiastic tone saying, we will have a wonderful journey. That was excellently done. All the role players, including Table Topics Master and Court Master and EDM Master, did wonderful job. Table Topics Master gave topics which are really thought-provoking, which is very required for any table topics. Good job on that. Let me spend a few minutes on providing some improvements. I know there was some confusion with the objectives of one speech. That is fine. Sometimes it happens when we meet virtually, but we were able to recover very quickly. That is a good thing. Next thing, I request people to switch on their cameras. It is my personal opinion. I feel really not happy to give speech to computer in the first place, and I am not feeling energetic to give that. On top of that, giving speech to bunch of names is even more confusing for people like me. Instead of that, if you can follow like DTM Nina Jan or Abhirami, I can see they are nodding their heads when they are listening, and they are pacing and they are smiling. When I see that when I am speaking, I will feel more energetic. So as long as you don't have any distractions at your place, please switch on your cameras and dedicate these 2 hours. If you are meeting in person, you will not be moving out of the room. So make sure these 2 hours, assume that you are meeting in person and don't move out and sit there and dedicate these 2 hours. And most importantly, we are not going to judge you by what you are saying in your speech. Similarly, we are not going to judge you by what you have in your background. If you are worried about that, get a green screen like Madam Nina, or definitely your house have a wall like this, so use that. But switch on your cameras, show your face so that people will get that energy to give the speech. And next, guests should be introduced in the beginning because it is a virtual meeting. they may feel let out if we don't introduce them in the beginning. So in a regular meeting, even if we miss, that is fine. But in virtual meeting, guests should be introduced in the beginning, in my opinion. That's it. My report overall, CTM always keeps its great standards and it is wonderful meeting. And I am always happy to be part of this meeting. Thank you. And that is my report. And can we have voting for best role player? Thank you for voting. Let us have our Toastmaster back. Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Vatika.
Thank you so much, distinguished Toastmaster Ram, for such a detailed report and polishing our speakers. I would request the host to launch the leftover polls.
MOD.
Okay. Thank you so much. I think it is time for me to conclude the theme. You must have now realized by now that there could be n number of such what ifs, right? Let me give you another one. What if Earth was the size of the sun? All our problems of expensive property, expensive land, overpopulation would be resolved, right? Wrong. Because if Earth's radius was even the slightest centimeter greater than what it is now, we would not even be able to stand up. We would be hit by asteroids every single hour. So while I was surfing the internet to search for the content for this theme, I realized that we generally do not appreciate what we have, not just in terms of our near and dear ones, but also in terms of science. We had been given a perfectly balanced ecosystem and we had no right to disturb this balance. But now that it has been disturbed, it is our responsibility that at the least we should maintain this. Let us be grateful to our Mother Nature, to our universe, and to all the incidents that happened because of which humanity exists, and prevent it from further deterioration. This universe has given us a lot to be thankful for. It is high time for us now to pay back. With this, I hand over the controls to our presiding officer, Toastmaster Guruvayurappan. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. Over to you, presiding officer.
We have one more rating about the quality of meeting run. I request your host to launch the poll. Dear all, and we are at the end of a wonderful meeting of Vendor 746. It is our custom to honor those who break the ice and to those who complete the project. So let's unmute yourself. Give big round of applause for Lakshmi Narayana for giving his icebreaker speech. and Rekha for completing her level 1 project. Please give big round of applause. Now, next guest feedback. Guest Hari.
I'm actually frequenting this club after 6 months. I thought somehow the club will open and I can come to the open club. But I guess this will be the new way. And so wanted to join back.
Thank you. Welcome back, Hari. Now, guest Devi.
Yes, thank you so much for giving me this wonderful opportunity. And I would like to say that, you know, I have learned a lot, like the Toastmaster said, this culture example, that is the artist, it was already there, but it's our duty to just remove the bits and pieces to show off. So that's a very wonderful thing about it. I hope it's true when it comes to this platform. Thank you so much for giving me this as a guest role. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other guest? Guest Roop Singh?
Yeah, thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to learn the
Hello?
Part. And the way
Any other guest?
The way topics are covered here really, really excellent. And this will really give insights to the communication skill and other leadership part in the management side. So really, it's a very, very great experience for me. So once again, thank you. Thank you, Toastmaster, for giving me the opportunity. Thanks.
With this, we come to the end of meeting. Now it's time for me to declare the results. Best ADM / Toastmaster goes to TM Abhirami. Please give big round of applause. Best Tag Player Award goes to Toastmaster Jimmy Grammarian. Best Role Player Award goes to Toastmaster Vrithika, Toastmaster of the Day. Best Evaluator goes to Toastmaster Speaker. Best TT Speaker Award goes to Toastmaster Kritika. DTM Best Drupal Speaker Award goes to DTM Neena Jha.
Thank you.
Award DTM Neena Jha. Meeting was, today's meeting was excellent and voting result was very tight. So overall meeting rating is 8.5 out of 10. So with this, I adjourn the meeting 7:46 to next week. Now let's join for an informal gathering.
Can everyone please switch on your cameras and just take a
break? Yeah.
All the guests will be having a guest briefing session. Abhiram would be taking that. I will give you a request for moving to the breakout room. Wait for it.
What, Sanju?
Sorry, couldn't hear you.
No, no, go ahead, go ahead. Actually, I was telling about guest briefing, but it seems there are very few guests at this point.
I think DTM Ram had a very valid point. Like the guest in a virtual meeting ideally should be introduced in the beginning. So that actually, because otherwise they don't get an idea on what is going on. Because in a physical meeting, it's okay, they are in the room and they get to see it. But in a virtual meeting, they should be roped in at the beginning itself.
And also about this camera, what is mentioned, that's very valid.
Right. Absolutely. It's I when I put on the gallery view, I see only blank screens. So,
I think we are, the meeting is still being recorded. Sorry to interrupt, ma'am. I think the recording is still being on.
Singapore Toastmasters have a rule key. All of you have to keep, compulsorily keep your video on.
Yeah, I think we should also do that. Yeah, is it only members or?
Yeah, it's only members.
Guests are in the...
We do have one guest here.
So who's that?
I think guest.
It's nothing very secret. I just wanted to talk about the fact that what we have in Pathways. I've just started Pathways. So I just did my icebreaker a couple of weeks ago, so naturally it was very understandable that what I was doing, speech two of that project. But what I did was I looked at all the different levels and what you have to do for each of these, and I would request all of you also to do that, right? Because at level 4 and 5 there are different projects that need to be done. Now, there is something called a high performance leadership project, which you can take up the project. Basically, you take up a project of some kind. You have 2 or 3 people guiding you, helping you analyze your own leadership style and do all of these things. You have a subcommittee which will carry out the task. So you're basically learning how to manage, execute, and deliver. All right. Now, the thing is, HPL also requires you to introduce to the club the fact that you're doing an HPL. I don't know why, but we don't seem to have had very many introductory speeches for the HPL, so nobody knew what that HPL was. And the thing is, the HPL can take 1 week, a month, or 6. This one is going to take me 9 months. So I cannot wait till I finish all my level 4 speeches to start that project. So this mentor pool project requires a committee to be formed to carry out the tasks. And as I said, I will have 2 people in the guidance committee, so they will guide me for that. All those who are going to be part of the mentor pool committee, I have asked them also to do HPL for themselves, so that we have more people doing HPL. HPL will be part of the Pathways. So I would request all of you to go check your Pathways, all the projects. Now, for example, Presentation Mastery, I think, asks you to set up a social media presence.
Catch up.
And I think there is something about doing a podcast. Now you can wait till Project 3 and 4 speeches are over before you start doing your podcast or setting up a social media presence. So I would request all of you to please go through that. There are things like sponsoring a YP, youth leadership YLP leadership program, or coaching a club, mentoring. So all of you, please look at your own path, whatever it is. Look at the projects required. Some of the electives, PL is an elective for... it's not mandatory for all the parts, but it is there for most of it. So please look at it, see if you need to do it. Start working on the projects right now. And then just submit it to the club or for the thing when it is over. All right? So that's a bit of advice that I wanted to give for all of you.
Regarding the high-performance leadership itself, even I have it in my effective coaching pathway. It's in level 5. What can I use as a part of my leadership to qualify for that, what do I have to, like you said that you're coaching a mentor pool, so like that, is there anything I can
see? You are now, for example, some disturbance. Any idea whose mic that is? Okay, thank you. Yeah, so for area director now, for example, you may have set up an area council, right? You have 3 or 4 people helping you.
Yes, I do.
Right? So that is your committee. So if you put that as an HPL, you have 2 or 3 people, you understand from them, how am I doing? What is my leadership style? So there is a format which is there. I'll send it to you. Venu sent it to me, so I'm sending it. I can send that to you. So you go through that for the requirements of what is the thing. So it's basically outlining your project. So like I said, my project is to set up a pool of mentors for D120. So in your case, it is to improve area C1's performance or any other criteria that you have. So who are the people who are going to carry out the tasks? So you've got your area council, someone looking after your education, someone looking after your club growth, PC points. So these are 3 or 4 people who will be your committee.
Yes.
So you have, so your term is basically till the end of the year. So your area directorship can be your HPL also.
I was looking into this and not have any idea. So I thank you so much, ma'am. I can use this and start my project as well.
No, because it's going to take anything from, it's going to take you 1 year. So start it at least now and say, this is how you're doing it. Choose your guidance committee, get some senior Toastmasters to help you. And your committee will be your whoever is helping you. Sorry, your voice is gone.
Ma'am, would you be a part of my committee as well, ma'am?
I walked right into that, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, sure, I'll do that. I'm resigning. Catch Ram. He was a superb division director, right? Division governor. What was it? Ram, what did you do?
Ram.
Ram Mohan.
Yes.
You were division director, is it?
No, area director.
Catch him because he did a superb job as area director.
Mom, so
he'll give you lots of ideas. He'll tell you how
to problem.
You can see people. Yeah.
Ram and you, ma'am. So both of you are on this call. Can you both be part of my committee?
This is how she became area director. Seizing opportunities. Yeah, sure. We can do that.
I actually went to purchase one washing machine long back. It's a BPL and there is an IFB washing machine center. Both they placed it nearby each shop. So one person started bargaining and by hearing it out, the other person also started bargaining. Whatever they do, they are reducing the price. It's benefit for me. So the nomination is here is going Dina ma'am and Ram sir, both of them came up together and it's beneficial for Nadria ma'am.
She's got ask one and get two free. So she's got two guidance people for the one. No, the rest of you, please start. Guru, I think you can already do that, right? You can always, Guru is part of the mentor pool. So I would suggest, you already asked for one person from this club. Take one from each of the other clubs to cover your division. So you've got your committee ready. And again, look at other people for your guidance thing. And because that will also be your HPL. So you can use that. So rest of you start thinking in terms of your pathways, projects. Which are the ones you all are doing? So, I don't know. Jimmy,
I have Naveen. with HPL. HPL is like, I don't even know what HPL is. Along the lines of my pathway, ma'am, I have only three speeches left because I've been giving education sessions all across Synergy and Eloquent. So suddenly now it's like, okay, now that I have much left, I didn't know how to go about HPL. So the next step, thank God, it came up on its own.
I don't know. There's a lack in our about presenting this the way it should be done. So, again, everyone kind of think about this. So, what are the rest of you all doing about your pathways? Anyone, any help you need? Any ideas?
My mentor is Venu. He gave me a suggestion like to deliver my speech to other clubs as well. So that I get more practice, right? So how do we choose the clubs? How do I get to know there are slots available in clubs? Is there any? I know there is.
Contact Ranju.
Ranju, yeah.
Contact Ranju. It's just whenever he posts a message that he needs a speaker for other clubs, we just nominate yourself, we just tell them. Whenever there is a requirement from other club, he will assign you. So contact Ranju.
Also, I think there are messages appearing on, I don't know, all the different club WhatsApp groups. Any of your friends, just pass a message to your club friends in other clubs. And ask them, and if there's a, they can put you onto the VP, and you can take up a slot.
Okay.
So now everything is virtual, so you can have corporate clubs, you can have community clubs. It really depends on your convenience. Yeah, just go through the website, Toastmasters website, or find a club near you, and whichever club is convenient, just ask them if there's a slot. Say you want to speak, and go ahead and. And the other tip I would like to give all of you is that a lot of the things can be done outside the club. It's actually meant for your professional competency. Pathways is meant for your professional competencies. So there are, you see if there are projects that you deliver as part of your office and official work. Keep Ranju aware of that as a VPE. Present that speech outside. Preferably by a Toastmaster or otherwise anybody, any other colleague. And let Ranju see that and you can upload that. So everything doesn't have to be inside CTM meetings.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right.
Madam, I
and
have
your projects can.
Sorry, madam.
Sorry?
Proceed. Sorry, proceed.
No, you're attending another four meetings, is it?
Yes. Then.
Oh, wow.
November 1st, timing will change. So I have to wake up at 4:30 if I have to attend CTM meetings. 4:30 Sunday morning is a bit difficult.
I agree. So how long will that be? 3 months, is it?
Is 6 months.
Is it?
Yeah, 6 months, 6 to 7 months. And, yes, I'm moving to Coromandel so that I can continue wake up at 5:30 on a Saturday. That is somewhat better.
So I hope you only shift your speeches and not your membership. Membership has to stay with CTM. Membership has to stay with CTM. Speakers you can give wherever you want, whatever time you want. We have no. Where is Abhilash? Okay, Abhilash has been staying. So put some conditions when all members do all these things.
Yeah, that too, next month onwards, it is going to be minus temperatures in the early morning. So it is going to be difficult.
First, when you said I'm shifting to Coromandel, I thought you were shifting physically to Coromandel. Then I was realized, no, you're only shifting the club. Yeah, anybody else? Any other questions about, Puneet? Yeah, question?
I think he just realized that.
Back to open. Okay, any other open discussion, please go back to the thing.
Only thing is, I am really struggling to give speeches in Zoom. I am not comfortable at all. I don't know how to overcome that. I am constantly getting distracted when giving speeches.
No, I'm not quite comfortable. I just sit here and give the speech. So and now I got my green screen, which everyone insisted on making such a fuss about, I swear. So I'm quite comfortable with this, but I need to get some.
Technically,
yeah, Madhuri, you were saying something?
Toastmaster Ram's first speech when he gave on August 16th had such an impact on me that in the combined meeting with,
World Bank.
Yeah, with World Bank Chennai Toastmasters Club, I even made a mention of your speech in my prepared speech. So if you don't know, you can maybe check the recording to see what exactly you might have inspired a whole script out of me. So maybe that would inspire your next speech.
Well, even the World Bank president, he mentioned your name. I mean, I'm also equally bald, so he actually mistook me as you, who spoke about the investment proposals and everything. So I could realize that speech has been impactful. It stays in people's mind.
Yeah, I did a poor job in conveying my message. I was not happy with my own speech on investments. I was completely unprepared. But my intention was nobody should do the same mistakes what I did.
Well, so people have taken it seriously.
Good. Okay. So.
Okay. Thank you. It was wonderful meeting. Anybody else? I'm leaving. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, all. Take care.
Bye, everyone.